Good morning everyone. Today I am going to teach you the subject EVS and this is the lecture for class 4 and chapter number 3, lecture number 2. In this lecture, in previous lecture, I already give you the description about the, there are mainly two types of animals. Some animals are laying eggs and some animals give birth to their young ones. By emphasizing on the animals which lay eggs, I already discussed about few animals. In this lecture, I am going to give you the knowledge about the butterfly. What is the life cycle of butterfly? Butterfly have a unique way of reproduction because we see that the different animals lay egg on land, some animals lay egg on their nest, some animals lay egg in water, but butterfly have unique way of reproduction. They lay their egg on leaf. Butterfly lay eggs on leaf. Okay, the larva, a small worm like creature, comes out from the egg, which is known as caterpillar. We already see the green color creature. This is the, when butterfly lay eggs on leaf. The butterfly lay eggs on leaf. So remember this, while I am giving you the multiple choice questions also, and the exam is also going to be happen. So you have to emphasize on different terms, that where the different animals gives lay, and what is also the name of different stages also, and the butterfly lay eggs on leaf. After some time egg becomes mature and it develops into a caterpillar. The next stage of life cycle is egg becomes caterpillar. The egg develops into a caterpillar, okay, and this caterpillar or the larva which come out from that particular egg, it eats plenty of leaf for growth and development. A protective covering also there, we see that in leaf. Different time we see that on leaf there are small eggs present on leaf. These eggs once becomes a caterpillar, a small worm like structure we see on leaf several times. This small caterpillar develops from this egg. Then after that, this is the caterpillar. Okay, this is the caterpillar having green color or different color, that depends on their parent animals, and they then on some larva also came out from this caterpillar. Butterfly built a protective shed, white color or a protective layer on that particular caterpillar. So it develops a protective covering around itself. This is termed as pupa, and this is termed as pupa. Now from egg develops into a caterpillar, and by giving a protective layer on that particular caterpillar, this is termed as pupa. This stage is known as pupa. Okay, this stage is known as pupa. Then after that, after eating the plenty of leaves, the pupa shed its skin several times. This pupa change its skin several times. Several times it changes its skin. This shedding of the skin is known as moulting. The process by which a pupa shed their skins means skin ko change karna. Okay, so this is known as moulting. This process is known as moulting. Moulting is the process by which a pupa shed their skin. Okay, so this is known as moulting. After the different several changing of their skin, a pupa becomes a butterfly. It becomes an adult butterfly. Then after that, this butterfly again lay egg, and it then again egg becomes caterpillar, it develops a proper shell, proper coverage. Then after that, this is the stage which comes when a caterpillar becomes a pupa. After different times, several times, pupa shed their skin. The process of shedding skin is termed as moulting, and then after that it becomes an adult butterfly. This is the life cycle of butterfly, where the butterfly lay eggs. The butterfly lay eggs on leaves. Where the frog lay eggs, frog lay eggs in the water. Okay, and what are the eggs of frog look like? It just look like jelly, and that jelly like structure or jelly like eggs is termed as spawn. All these things are very very common to you all, and you have to learn several times this these things. The next one is, after this butterfly, the next one is cockroach and grasshopper. Now look the life cycle of cockroach and grasshopper. They also lay eggs. We already see cockroach in our house also. The different stages of their lives. Okay. And grasshopper. Cockroaches and grasshopper. Okay. The three main steps or three main stages in the life cycle of cockroach and grasshoppers. You all see the grasshoppers. Grasshoppers in these days also, this is very very in news also, because this is in Hindi, this is termed as tiddi. Okay. You see in news also that the tiddi attack or tiddi moves from Pakistan or from Pakistan area to India also. So this is the grasshopper. Grasshopper just green color creature. Now look at the life cycle of cockroach and grasshopper. There are mainly three stages. They also lay eggs. Then this eggs convert into nymph. At first, there are main three stages of life cycle of the cockroach and grasshopper. First stage of formation is called, is termed as nymph. Nymph is the second stage, the development of eggs into nymph. The third one is that is the larva. It means when egg hatches, it becomes nymph. After some days or after few hours also, I don't know very clear, the eggs get the proper proper temperature, proper condition from the environment, and it hatches and it develops into a nymph. After this, the larva comes out when the egg hatches, and they resemble a lot of their parent. After the process of moulting several times, they develop into an adult. So this is, the term pupa is not used here. The second stage is nymph, and then after shedding their skin, the shedding of skin, the process of shedding skin is also known as moulting. And after several times, nymphs shed their skin and then become a adult cockroach or grasshopper. Or grasshopper. So this is the life cycle of cockroach and grasshopper. Cockroach and grasshopper lay eggs, then egg becomes mature and hatches after some times, and it becomes nymph after several times, nymph shedding their skins and develop into an adult cockroach and a grasshopper. Then after that, this individual again lay eggs, and this life cycle is a continuous life cycle. Okay, now the next one is reptiles. What's the meaning of reptiles? Reptiles is the creature, animals having no leg, or even if they have leg also, they used to walk like, what I am saying, that. As for example, snake it come under the category of reptiles. Okay, snake and lizards, all these comes in the category of reptiles. Reptiles lay egg on land, not in water, or it lay eggs on land, on the ground. So this is very important to you all, that where the reptiles lay egg on the ground. The reptiles, as for example, snake and lizards are the reptiles. Most of the reptiles also lay egg on in water and in different places, but especially snake and lizards, these two reptiles lay eggs on the ground. Okay, but only some eggs from the total number of egg laid hatches, because all the eggs not get the proper condition, proper temperature. That's why most of the eggs become destroyed, and some of eggs which get the proper incubation, proper temperature, proper warmth needs, they hatches with the help of that warmth from the sun. The warmth coming from the sun, that heat gives the proper incubation to those eggs, and then egg hatches and develop into a new ones. The rest are eaten by the other animals also. So this is the life cycle of reptiles. Reptiles lay eggs on the ground. So, reptiles like snake and lizard, I am not telling about all reptiles. Okay, reptiles lay reptiles as for example snake and lizard lay eggs on the ground, and they get the proper incubation or proper after proper incubation, that is after proper condition, proper temperature, proper warmthness coming from the sun, they become an adult, or they become the new young ones come out from that particular egg, and then it become adult reptiles. Then again this reptile lay egg, and this is the continuous process. This is the life cycle of reptiles. Okay, this is very clear to you all, that the how oviparous, what is oviparous animals, the egg laying animal is termed as oviparous. The different animals like birds, frog, butterfly, hen, or reptiles, and even cockroach and grasshopper, all these things are discussed here. And now the next one is animals which give birth to their young ones, which is also termed as viviparous animals. So this is the all which is related to oviparous animals. Oviparous animals are those animals which lay egg. With the help of laying egg, they give birth to their young ones. Now the next one is animals which give birth to babies. Yes. Animals give birth to babies. Some animals like mammals, okay? Animals which give birth to babies. Some animals, those animals are termed as mammals. Mammals are the animals give birth to their young ones. It means just as they are, they give birth to their young ones directly. The new babies there is no process of laying egg, incubation, molting and metamorphosis. All these processes are not happening in these type of animals, in mammals. Even we people come into our existence directly in the form of babies. Okay, so mammals are the animals that give birth to young ones. They give young ones with their own kind. Okay, so mammals, this is termed, those animals which give birth to their young one is termed as mammals. Okay, these animals is termed as mammals. So these mammals give birth to their young ones, and they suckle their young ones with their milk after the birth. It means the new babies feed with their mother in the form of milk. Some common examples of mammals are, different examples are also we human being, cats, monkeys, elephants, kangaroo, many more things like whales also. So these creatures are giving birth to their young ones as they are, and all these animals are come under the category of mammals, also known as mammals. And mammals feed their young ones in the form of milk. And the different examples already I given you, that elephant, cat, dog, you human beings. And elephant, many more animals which come under the whales also, which come under the category of mammals, give birth to their young ones as they are. The young ones of the animal develop completely inside the mother body. Okay, in these type of animals, the young ones develop inside of the mother body. Okay, and then after that, when they are born, they have hair on the body. Ma'am, the new ones having hair on their body, hair also well developed. The brain is also well developed. So the lungs also developed, brain developed. They, even when they came into existence, the brain, their lungs, they start breathing. All these things will develop in the inside the mother's body only. So some mammals like whales, dolphin, etc., all these animals live in water, but most of the mammals live on land. Some mammals like whales, dolphins, all these mammals live in water, but most of the mammals like a human being, cat, dog, elephants, all these type of animals live on land. Okay, so some mammals are known as aquatic mammals and some mammals are known as terrestrial mammals. So aquatic mammals are those mammals as we already discussed in chapter number 2, what the aquatic plants which live in water. So aquatic mammals are those mammals which live in water, as for example dolphins and whales. Okay, most of the mammals take care of their babies for long time. Even our parents take care their children like me and like you. So the parent take care of their babies for long time. They keep them safe, clean and provide them food also. Mammals like fish, whales, etc. do not take care of their young ones because they live in water. And after the new baby learn how to swim, how to catch their prey, then they become free and the parents not take proper care, and they live in their own. Okay, so all these things are related with the mammals when mammals when the parent animals give birth to their young ones, there are some features like their hair on their body, and the brain is well developed, the lungs also well developed. When the new baby came into existence or take birth, they start breathing also. So these are the concept which is related to the animals which give birth to their babies. By this I have already completed this chapter, and continue study by your home only, and get ready for your periodic test also, because this is the chapter which is in your syllabus. Okay, thank you.